And there are seven kings, five are fallen, and one is, and the other is not yet come. And when he cometh, he must continue a short space. And the beast that was, and is not, even he is the eighth, and is of the seventh, and goeth into perdition.
Very great Andrew Jackson. From poverty and obscurity, Jackson rose to glory and greatness, first as a military leader and then as the seventh president of the United States. It was during the Revolution that Jackson first confronted and defied an arrogant elite. Does that sound familiar to you? I wonder why they keep talking about Trump and Jackson, Jackson and Trump. Oh, I know the feeling, Andrew. Does that sound familiar to you? I wonder why they keep talking about Trump and Jackson, Jackson and Trump. Trump and Jackson, Jackson and Trump. Trump and Jackson, Jackson and Trump.
Look who's in the painting today. It's President Andrew Jackson. Let's see if we can wake him up. Wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up.
What is happening? Where am I?
The seventh president of the United States.
Tonight, for the first time, I am releasing my official birth video.
Well, now we come to talk about The Lion King. How many people have seen The Lion King?
And one is, and the other is not yet come.
And I know just the guy to do it. Donald Trump is here tonight.
And when he cometh, he must continue a short space. And the beast that was, and is not, even he is the eighth, and is of the seventh, and goeth into perdition.
Many people, for instance, were inspired by the King's speech.
With God's help, we shall prevail.
Wonderful film. Well, some of you may not know this, but there's now a sequel in the works that touches close to home.
If we were to count the kings, what sign would God give us to help us know where to begin counting the kings? President number 38 is known to be Gerald Ford, but that was not the name he was born with. His original last name was King. When he was a baby, his parents divorced, and when his mother remarried, he took the name of his stepfather. He could have been a King, his biological father's last name, but he was renamed Ford. And he was not elected, but appointed, as kings are.
Then, in 1974, Nixon resigned over the Watergate scandal, and Ford became the unelected 38th President of the United States.
However, he did not serve a full term. he filled the office of president until the next election. Ford's path to presidency was a very unusual one.
In 1973, Vice President Spiro Agnew resigned in disgrace. Ford's life took an unexpected turn.
My fellow Americans, I proudly present to you the man whose name I will submit to the Congress of the United States for confirmation as the Vice President of the United States, Congressman Gerald Ford of Michigan.
Rumors of President Nixon's imminent resignation swept Washington and the world today.
President Nixon reportedly will announce his resignation tonight.
I, Gerald R. Ford, do solemnly swear that I will faithfully execute
the office of President of the United States.
The office of President of the United States.
And will, to the best of my ability.
And will, to the best of my ability.
Preserve, protect, and defend.
Preserve, protect, and defend.
Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
So help me God.
So help me God.
I have not campaigned either for the presidency or the vice presidency. I have not sought this enormous responsibility.
My fellow Americans, I once asked you for your prayers, and now I give you mine. May God guide this wonderful country, its people, and those they have chosen to lead them. May our third century be illuminated by liberty and blessed with brotherhood, so that we, and all who come after us, may be the humble servants of thy peace. Amen. Good night. God bless you.
The man who could have been a king was renamed Ford. And a ford is a place in a river, a stream, or other body of water where people may cross over. I believe Gerald Ford is the dividing line, and the presidents after him are the kings, referred to by Revelation 17, verse 10.
But I assume the presidency under extraordinary circumstances never before experienced by Americans. I am acutely aware that you have not elected me as your president by your ballots. But there is a higher power, by whatever name we honor him, who ordains not only righteousness but love, not only justice but mercy. And let brotherly love purge our hearts of suspicion and of hate.
Wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up.
And the beast that was and is not, even he is the eighth, and is of the seventh, and goeth into perdition.